Life of another person in that car was changed because of the accident. Chelsea Hill paralyzed from the waist down. She had to stay in the hospital for 2 months and is still trying to rebuild her life. Action News reporter Stephanie Truong is live in our Salinas newsroom with an update of her condition.
Hi, Dan. Well, neither Chelsea nor her father, John, wanted to comment on Aaron Korn's latest update because of the under the advice of their attorney. But the latest we know is that they did, along with another passenger in the car, Matthew Wheeler, file a lawsuit back in September for medical expenses. So that is still going on. As for Chelsea, since the accident, her main focus, of course, has been to be able to walk again. She's been in rehabilitation centers to get her back on her feet, and even joined the Colors in Motion dance team. So she's doing well. But one of Chelsea's biggest goals is to speak to students about making the right decisions. This is what she told us back in October.
I think about that night every day. I mean, I have this chair to remind me of my choice that I made. And what if I did get dropped off second? What if I didn't get in the car? What if I walked home, you know? I could go crazy thinking about the what ifs, but I can't. And I have to think, okay, now what if I do this with my life? And what's going to happen if I do start a foundation? Who am I going to help?
Now, as for the Hill's attorney, it is Monterey-based attorney Bob Rosenthal. We did try calling him today to get an update on that lawsuit for the medical expenses. No call back. So, Dan, we're still working on it.
All right. Thank you very much. Appreciate it, Stephanie. Aaron Korn's defense attorney says part of his client's sentencing is expected to include educational outreach to other students on the dangers of drunk driving.